this time, we ask you to please stand for the national song.
Welcome to everyone. The school leaving ceremony of the class of 2020 is certainly a historic one. The school leavers today were the first set of reception students. We're also the first students in the history of the school to have a virtual school leaving ceremony, and it is my pleasure to welcome you. A special welcome to our invited guests, principal and staff, family, friends, boys and girls. Prospect Primary School has prepared us to be lifelong learners and global citizens. Our experiences throughout the past 7 years have been memorable, and we all share a common bond. We will definitely remember words such as integrity, respect, care, and appreciation. Events and activities such as Heritage Day, Career Fair, Festival of Arts, Sports Day, and School Devotions have prepared us, along with our academics, to receive the challenges ahead. I'm filled with excitement and anticipation, as the next phase of our lives is about to begin. However, this virtual event would not have been possible without the support of our parents, our guardians, and our teachers, classmates, and fellow school leavers. We're about to depart the foundation of our primary years, Prospect Primary, the best school in the whole wide world. May the years to come be kind to all of us, and may God in His wisdom bless us with success. Special guest, principal and staff, family, friends, and well-wishers, welcome to the Prospect Primary Virtual School Leaving Ceremony 2020. I now introduce our Masters of Ceremony, our head girl, Alexa Moyton, and our head boy, Isaiah Miles.
The school leaving class of 2020 has chosen a song that marks key events in our final year at Prospect Primary. This song has become an anthem for all of us. The song is called, I Will Remember. Little did we know that when we first learned it, just what significance it would have. The theme of tonight's ceremony is drawn from this song, along with the attributes, resilience and endurance, which have come to represent the school leaving class of 2020. We have chosen these themes because they remind us, firstly, of how much we have grown during our time at Prospect Primary School. They remind us that this is not goodbye, just a farewell.
The melody and message in this song tug at the heartstrings and remind us that in all we do, wherever we go, we must let the lessons that we have learned at school, home, and most importantly, in church, guide us. We are gently urged to hold on to our happy memories and friendships and continue to strive for excellence as we embark on new beginnings. We are celebrating today because Prospect Primary School has been a place where we have been nurtured and encouraged to shine bright like a beacon. Our school is a special place where we have bonded in friendships. Our victories, challenges, and escapades are memories that are etched in our minds. We might be feeling a bit nostalgic and a little nervous about what comes next, but our school and parents have worked hard to ensure that we are well prepared. I now invite Aiden Miller to lead us in prayer.
Dear Lord, as we commence this graduation ceremony, we bring before the graduates class of 2020, families, friends, and school staff of Prospect Primary School. Today, we close one chapter of our lives and begin a new one. Count our hearts that are filled with mixed emotions of joy, excitement, and some anxiousness. As we celebrate a step forward into a new stage of our lives at a different school with new people and new experiences, let us always remember the works of your hands, and may your blessings, grace, and favor continue to follow us. Prospect Primary School has been a safe place to learn and has provided us with a solid foundation to build upon. May the experience gained at this school always be embedded in our hearts. We thank you for our principals, teachers, and school staff who have so deeply loved and cared for us during the good and bad times. We are grateful for our families who have cheered us on and stood by our sides through the many bumps into the road of our development. Please continue to guide and protect the paths of our classmates as we remember all the laughs and tears that we have shared during the years. Help us to always seek your wisdom and will for our life. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We now invite Crystal Durant and Quintina Morales to share the scripture reading with us. Thank you.
I will share with you three messages from the Bible. Ecclesiastes 12, verse 1. Remember now thy Creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them. James 1, verse 12. Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because, having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. I will now invite Quintina Morales to give our second scripture reading.
Thank you, Crystal. I will also share three short readings with you. Colossians 1, verses 9 to 11. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have a great endurance and patience. 2 Corinthians 4, verses 8 to 9. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Jeremiah 29, verses 11. For I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your welfare, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. We now invite our principal, Mr. Matthew Reed, to give the principal's address.
Protocol having been established, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, everyone who is joining us virtually for this unique event, and of course, our school leaving class of 2020. Good evening. Back in November, Year 6 McEachron were looking at environmental issues in one of their lessons. I remember at the time asking the class if they knew who Greta Thunberg was. I was greeted by some nods and some blank looks, so I talked to them for a few minutes and explained why I thought she was important. I talked about the fact that I believed she was a hero for their generation, that she would be a name that went down in history. I felt it was important that they recognised her, so in years to come, they could say they had genuinely witnessed history in the making. something that they would remember. The year rolled on and life seemed to be normal. We broke up for the Christmas holidays, and over the break we welcomed in the new year and a new decade. Term 2 started and life seemed to carry on as normal. On January the 28th, we had an earthquake. It was a shock, but again, it was one for the memory. Yes, I was there. I remember the earthquake. But quite quickly, life settled back to normality. And there was a fire. Our students could say they had witnessed 3 historic events in their last year at primary school. More amazing memories from their time at Prospect. A few days of excitement, but before long, things settled into the familiar routine once again. But then, as we crept into March, normal went out of the window, and we all went from being witnesses to being participants in one of the truly momentous events in our world history. In just 6 short months, we have seen the whole world change, and we are now living truly extraordinary lives in truly extraordinary times. But when I say this event is unique, I don't mean it's unique because we're holding this ceremony virtually or because of the events that I've described. Because let's face it, for children all over the world, whether they are leaving their primary schools or their high schools or their universities, this is the new normal. This is how the end of academic year 2020 is being marked for millions of students. No. When I say this is a unique event, I'm referring to the fact that this year group are the first ever cohort to join us in reception and to have spent 7 years at Prospect Primary School. But even as we mark this milestone in the school's history, the truth is we would have remembered this group of students for their own merits anyway. The class of 2020 are a group of students who have grown to really exemplify the values of Prospect Primary School and our amazing community. This is a group of students of whom we can feel very, very proud. They are truly a lovely group of children and one that everyone who knows them speaks of fondly. They are helpful, conscientious, they are caring, and they always look out for each other. They show genuine consideration for each other's feelings and real compassion for one another. They're funny and they're good company. I cannot tell you the number of times they have reduced me to gales of laughter with a witty observation or a joke that they have cracked. Or what a pleasure it is just to sit down with them and chat at break time or lunchtime. They have been a joy to teach. They have grown and excelled academically, at sport and in the arts. They have won accolades at NCFA, on the football pitch, on the basketball court, on the track, on the field, on the stage, and in our wider community. Our girls are the national netball and basketball champions. And I think our boys would have matched the latter if the season had not been interrupted. But in the last few months, while you've missed each other, missed school, missed our old normal, you have never lost your spirit. You've shown resilience and strength. You've shown the very qualities that I know will ensure that you go on in your education and in your lives to make us all even prouder of each of you. You will always hold a very special significance in the history of Prospect Primary School. And this is why, even though we feel, like you, that we have been cheated out of our last few months together, we're always going to remember you. It's each of you that makes this a unique event. I am reminded that it takes a village to raise a child, a group of dedicated people to love, care, and nurture and guide young minds as they grow. Throughout their time with us, these students have grown as individuals, become more confident to the point where they have outgrown us, and I can say happily that despite this little interruption, they are now not only ready to progress to high school, they'll positively thrive there. These students have been well prepared for this next step in their educational journey by a loving and caring staff in a school environment that has nurtured them and guided them for 7 years. At this time, I would like to say thank you to all of the staff and parents and friends of the school who have worked together as a village to bring these fine people to today. So thank you to Mrs. Bell and Mrs. Law Gonzalez for being their first principal and vice principal, Mrs. Pink and Mrs. Cameron for being their reception teachers, Mrs. Miller and Mrs. Dixon, their year one teachers. Ms. Oxley Walker and Miss Watt-Galliano for being their year two teachers. Miss Elliot Walker and Miss Cameron for being their year three teachers. Miss Elliot Walker and Miss Scott for being their year four teachers. Miss Layla and Miss Harris for being their year five teachers. And for Miss McEachron and Miss Harris for being their year six teachers. To Miss Bravo and to Miss Howell for their support in year six, and particularly to Miss Bravo for our ongoing and constant support for this year group. Thank you to Miss Layla and Miss Ebanks King for your guidance for our prefects. They have helped in so many ways to ensure that the school has run smoothly and to set the example for others to follow. Ms. Oxley Walker for supporting the netball and cricket. To Ms. Scott, Coach Roach, Coach Evans, Coach Noel, Coach Benji and Ms. Cox for supporting their sporting endeavours. Mr. Hemans, Ms. Lingard and Mr. Earl LaPierre for supporting them musically. To Ms. Douglas Brown, Ms. Hardware, Ms. Johnson, Ms. Pierce, Ms. McField, Ms. Brown-Busham, Ms. Watler, Ms. Knight, Ms. Kidd, Ms. Solomon, Mr. Thomas, Ms. Rodney, Mr. Parker, Ms. Parchman, Nurse Alice, Nurse Sarah, Mr. Thomas, Mr. Connolly, to the whole Prospect team. They have been prepared for this transition by you, their supporting families, and the way that you have advocated for them. Encourage them, and I know that you will continue to be there for them as they move on to high school. I would like to thank all of you mums and dads and siblings, aunts, uncles and grandparents, and all of you who have given your time to homework, to projects, to supporting events, to support or to be part of the PTA, and particularly for supporting them during this time when we have been having to do distance schooling. You've been amazing. For your unswerving dedication to your children and to the support you have given Prospect as we have worked with you in partnership. Leavers, as you move on to the next stage of your academic journey, always remember that you are Prospect, and that as you face new challenges, always aim high. Hold true to yourselves and always live by the attitudes and values you have been taught here at Prospect Primary School. You carry with you our love and our expectations that you will always give your best no matter what, and that you will always be committed to excellence in all that you do. But most of all, take with you happy memories, and please make so many more. May God continue to bless you and guide you. Good luck.
Thank you for those inspiring and thought-provoking words, Mr. Reed. Your words will be lifelong lessons. We now invite Garson Gardner to introduce our keynote speaker, Mr. Jonathan Smellie.
Mr. Jonathan W.D. Smellie. Mr. Jonathan Smellie is a native Caymanian and was educated at Cayman Prep and High School between 1999 and 2011. He is a grandson of Ms. Esley Connolly, former Chief Education Officer, and Mr. Warren Connolly, former MLA for the District of East End and one of our national heroes. After graduating from Cayman Prep and High, he attended the University of Stirling in Scotland, where he obtained a Bachelor of Science degree with honors in cell biology. He subsequently obtained two Master of Science degrees, one in medical genetics and genomics from the University of Glasgow, Scotland, and the other in systems and synthetic biology from the University of Edinburgh, Scotland. At Glasgow University, Mr. Jonathan Smellie is currently working as a forensic assistant in the Health Services Authority Forensic Laboratory. He was employed to assist with the polymerase chain reaction, PCR, testing for the novel coronavirus disease, COVID-19, during the current pandemic. His role involves, amongst other things, the extraction of the genetic material for the testing. He enjoys fishing and stock trading in his spare time. Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow school leavers, I present to you Mr. Jonathan Smellie.
First, I'd like to thank the teachers and parents for giving me the honor of addressing the graduating class. Next, I'd like to congratulate the students for reaching another milestone in their lives. All of you boys and girls are still very young and have many years to decide what you want to be when you grow up. When I was your age, all I knew was that I liked catching bugs and playing marbles. But as I grew older, I realized I was interested in science. See, science is the way in which people can better understand the world in which we live in. It helps us live longer and healthier lives, create better medicines to treat diseases. What I do for a job is work with the other scientists in the Cayman Islands Forensics Lab to test people for the coronavirus. We then report those results to doctors and public health staff across the whole country. A big part of my job is purifying the sample so that only the virus is present and it can be detected accurately. This is called viral extraction. Here is a sample which may or may not have the virus inside of it. You put several chemicals inside the tube and shake it up so that the virus is killed and no longer able to infect us. Once this is done, the sample is then added to the testing kits that you've heard Dr. Lee and others speak about on the press conferences. This helps us multiply even the smallest bit of virus so that we can detect it properly. This is then loaded onto the PCR machine. We have three of these, as you can see here. Two of them are currently being used on a day-to-day basis. There are five of us in total doing the testing at the forensic lab, and we test hundreds of people a day. So far, we've tested nearly 18,000 people across the Cayman Islands. We work long hours most days, but it's very rewarding work, and it's a good example of how being a scientist can help make your country a better and safer place. I loved learning biology because it can be applied to improving the lives of others. But the great thing about science is that it can be applied to almost anything in life. So my advice would be that no matter what you're interested in, see if you can use science to figure out how it works, or if you can use it to make the world a better place. So congrats again, and remember that no matter what you want to be when you grow up, make sure you work very hard at it and don't let obstacles or challenges put you off of your goals. So thank you again for inviting me to speak, and all the best for the future.
Mr. Smelly, you have delivered your speech with such charisma. Thank you. It is our intention to heed these words as they propel us in the right direction. We now invite Tiana Ebanks to speak on behalf of the Year 6 students.
Protocol having been observed, on behalf of my fellow graduates, I wish to express how heartwarming it is to have everyone sharing this remarkable milestone in our lives. This virtual school leaving ceremony is a novel experience for Prospect Primary. But like troopers, we have risen to the occasion, and we, the graduates, shall soar to great heights because we have been taught to demonstrate tenacity. A few of us joined Prospect Primary School in different year groups, and we were welcomed with open arms. As we reminisce on our journey, it seemed like only yesterday most of my peers had entered reception under the leadership of Mrs. Gloria Bell and Vice Principal Mrs. Law Gonzalez. We traversed from the lower year groups to year 6, and now we are the first set to be graduating virtually. Is this a trend that's developing? If it is, I assure you that we will be the first in more positive things. Our principal, vice principal, and all our teachers nurtured us, engaged us in activities, and provided opportunities to increase our knowledge. We were given numerous opportunities to develop our aesthetic skills and showcase our creativity and prowess in internal and external competitions. A few tears have been shed, in victory and sadness sometimes. But this combination has made us more poised for transition to high school and further. We thank all the teachers who have prepared us for dance recitals and made sure our costumes were always ready. Our principal, vice principal, class teachers, assistants, PE coaches, steel pad instructor, and other trainers have all played vital roles in preparing us to participate in NCFA drama, musicals, spelling bee, football, netball, cricket, basketball, essay competitions, public speaking, Bible club, arts and crafts, scouts, brownies, among other events which have contributed to our growth in education. The PTA has been a provider for us in ways too numerous to be itemized, and we are truly grateful. Our gratitude also goes to the bus drivers, wardens, security guards, canteen staff, and janitors who have also contributed to our well-being. We are eternally grateful to our dear parents and guardians for their support. But parents, guardians, please remember, your role in our lives has no end. It's like a recurring decimal. Again, we, the school leaving class of 2020, express profound gratitude to our principal, vice principal, and all our teachers at Prospect Primary School. We also extend special thanks to our Year 6 class teachers, Ms. McEachran and Ms. Harris, for their contributions to our education. The invasion of COVID-19 in our lives has forced us to stay within the confines of our homes, where we had to interact with our teachers and classmates via online lessons. Zoom, WhatsApp, and other forms of technology rushed to our educational rescue. This too, we will remember. COVID-19 might have pressed the pause button momentarily, but Prospect Primary School has taught us to be bold, be courageous, be our best. Be resilient and exercise endurance wherever we go. This graduating class of 2020 will remember the bond that we have forged with Prospect Primary. This bond will stay forever, beyond distance, beyond time, because we were blessed by Jehovah God, who has been protecting us and providing for everyone. With God's continuous guidance, we will sparkle like diamonds as our work and attitude speak about our merits. Class of 2020 will remember, and so will you. We thank you.
Thank you, Tiana, for representing us while reminiscing about our journey at Prospect Primary School. At this time, we will now have our school leaver song.
We will remember.
Praise for grace.
Thank you, my fellow school leavers. Let's try to remember each other in a fond way as we prepare ourselves to experience high school. Let us treasure the good memories and lessons that we learned at Prospect Primary. This is the moment we have all been waiting for. The presentation of the school leaving certificates and awards. Each student will come forward to receive his or her graduation certificate, one at a time. Ms. McEachran will read the awards for the students of Year 6N, and Ms. Harris will read the awards for the students of Year 6H.
Andre Alexander. Andre is a lively and vocal student. He's a thinker and speaks his mind, whether or not anyone agrees with him. He reasons well about current events and mathematics. Andre is an active player of football and cricket. Maya Bates. Maya is a prefect. She's also an avid footballer who has captained the Prospect Primary School team. She's committed in trying to improve her academics performance. If you need someone to analyze and remedy a situation, then please find Maya. She's here to the rescue. I commend you, Maya, for thinking rationally. Sierra Bergman. Sierra is a prefect. She loves mathematics and shows steady growth in this subject. Once she gets the concept, I can rely on her to explain to her less competent peers. She plays football and basketball. She participates in long jump, 100 meters, 800 meters, and is an active member of the Cayman Islands Aquatic Club. Charles Chambers. Charles is a cricketer and footballer. He changes gears swiftly when math is being taught, and suddenly I'm faced with one of my most vibrant students. Charles is not afraid to make requests for me to do more math. Angel Connor. Angel is a very quiet student, but do not get the wrong impression. He will activate his mental mathematical capacity when he feels it's time to show me a thing or two. He loves science and is proving to me that he can talk when he thinks it really matters. Janae Cunningham. Janae is a prefect. She has participated in NCFA competitions, swimming, sailing, and has represented Prospect Primary School in netball. Janae expresses herself creatively and uses effective word choices in her writing. Alexander Diaz Ebanks. Alexander is a polite student who demonstrates a kind and thoughtful manner. He joined the class during term 2 and is adjusting well to expectations. Noah Downs. Noah loves singing, dancing, and drama. He is very aware of his surroundings and expresses his thoughts based on what he thinks the situation is. Tiana Ebanks. Tiana is a prefect. She is very attentive in class. She excels academically and has excellent penmanship, which seems to rival that which is typewritten. Her word choices evoke captivating mental images and makes interesting readings. She plays the piano, is a creative dancer, and a gymnast who competes locally and abroad. Garson Gardiner. Garson is a prefect. He thinks out of the box and excels academically. He loves mathematics and has won several awards for NCFA speech and writing, including the 2020 Rotary Essay Competition and first place in the 2020 Discovery Day competition in the 9 to 12 years old category. Garson plays the violin and has been awarded for his performance in this field. Khadija Gardner. Khadija is passionate about athletics and has represented her house and school in different events in sports. She is a force to be reckoned with on the track. Gemma General. Gemma is a prefect. She's a sharp-witted mathematician. If she were a magician, I think she would wave her wand and let math be the order of the day. Gemma possesses good debating skills, which come to the fore when a topic captures her interest. Gemma was invited to the governor's house to read her essay that she had written about Universal Children's Day. She's a creative dancer. She plays steel pan, basketball, netball, and participates in track and field. Anaya Lopez. Anaya is a peaceful student, and the effort that she puts into her schoolwork shows a lot of promise. She too was invited to the governor's house to read her essay that she had written about Universal Children's Day. Anaya is an active participant in netball, basketball, and dancing. Gisela McCoy. Gisela exercises great effort to improve her academic performance and is always willing to explain to her less competent peers. Gisela is very observant and she keeps me on target with things to do. She's very alert in reminding me, "Miss, it's your due today." It's very refreshing to listen to the application of strategies that she uses to solve math problems. And she thinks beyond the text when doing comprehension. Isaiah McCain. Isaiah is an active participant in football, basketball, and track and field. His achievements in academics and athletics are commendable. I now remind him to keep his eyes on the prize because he has the potential to rise.
Amaya McLaughlin. Amaya possesses good thinking skills and writes creative ideas, which give a glimpse into the recesses of her mind. Amaya, reach for the stars and never give up. That bud nestled within those sepals shall burst forth into a picturesque flower if you exercise tenacity.
Alexa Moyton. Alexa is head girl of Prospect Primary School. She's an alert student who excels academically and volunteers to explain numeracy and literacy concepts. Alexa is an all-rounder in sports and other areas of her school life. She's like a decorated veteran with remarkable achievements in netball, football, basketball, swimming, sailing, steel pan, and she has earned awards in NCFA speech, creative dancing, recording, drama, and the school choir. She has been runner-up for the champion girl in track and field, and she has done very well in events such as high jump, 100 meters, 200 meters, 4x100 meters, and the list goes on. Alexa's sterling performances sets the trend for a very interesting resume. Quintina Moraes. Quintina is a prefect. She's a very quiet student, but her good behavior and high standard of work boast of her excellence. She has represented her school in football, netball, and basketball. Quintina is also the recipient of awards in NCFA speech and dance, and she's a member of the school choir. Sabina Marie Motika Bush. Sabina Marie is a member of the school choir and has represented her school at the NCFA. She is a sociable student and is demonstrating ownership of her learning by volunteering responses during teaching and learning. Isaiah Miles. Isaiah is the head boy of Prospect Primary School. He is very committed to his schoolwork, excels academically, and is a fervent mathematician. Isaiah maintains a calm demeanor, displays a focused and positive behavior regardless of any nearby disturbances. Isaiah's credentials give him a lengthy brag sheet, but I'll give a sneak preview. He represented his school at the swimming gala and won gold and silver medals. Isaiah also won 2 silver medals at the 2020 Cayman Islands Aquatic Swimming Association National Championships. He has participated in sailing, basketball, cricket, and track and field. I wonder how many people knew that Isaiah obtained a junior black belt via Cayman Karate Academy. In a nutshell, Isaiah is someone who rises to challenges. Kezia Parchment. Kezia puts a lot of effort in improving her academic performance. She is an enthusiastic athlete who has successfully represented her school in football, netball, basketball, and track and field. She has also proudly worn the crown of Infant Champion Girl. Kezia is a member of the National Youth Culinary Program in the Cayman Islands, where she is trained to concoct mouth-watering cuisine. For future catering services, you may consider Kezia. Rayan Picard. Rayan has blossomed into a vocal and alert learner who volunteers math solutions. He's passionate about science and becomes very animated when he discusses animals in the wild. Rayan is a lover of nature, and he's self-driven to write pages and pages of his thoughts. Then he comes to me and say, "Miss, can you read my essay?" If my feedback seems delayed, Rayan will come back and say, "Miss, did you read my essay?" Of course, my feedback starts a whole new discussion, and I have to remind him, "It's time for your lunch, Rayan," or "It's time for your break." He doesn't go willingly. Brianna Ramjeet Flores. Brianna is a prefect. She has a very quiet disposition, and I have to coin my questions in a peculiar manner to evoke a lot of responses from her. She does well academically and interacts peacefully with her peers. Brianna plays the steel pan and is a member of the choir and creative dance group. Emmy Ramos. Emmy plays basketball, football, and netball. She has been a valuable member of the school teams and has helped to bring home several victories. Emmy brings life to her group in class, and I can rely on her to share ideas about math concepts. Nasir Smith. Nasir has made long strides in doing mathematics. He vocalizes solutions and counters the ideas of others until they can convince him with strong evidence. Nasir has an insatiable appetite for victory. He is a talented all-rounder who plays cricket and basketball. He makes the track come alive in different areas of track and field. Nasir is an agile footballer who has rivaled other teams to bring victories to his school. Tevez Varona. Tevez possesses tons of zest. He keeps the classroom buzzing with opinions, solutions, and his signals always beckon me to be on the alert. Tevez has an aptitude for mathematics, and he reasons very well. He's an asset to his school's cricket and football teams, and he has participated in swimming and sailing. Leah Warren. Leah is a prefect. She excels in literacy and mathematics and can be relied on to think of another way to explain math solutions. Leah expresses her thoughts freely whenever she feels to voice an opinion. She has been actively involved in the areas of basketball, netball, swimming, sailing, and creative dancing. Jair Willis. Jair has made commendable growth in mathematics and is becoming more vocal in expressing his thoughts. He plays basketball, cricket, and is brilliant in different areas of track and field. Jair is a rising football star and has been the 2020 top goal scorer in his league. He's a doting fan of the famous Brazilian footballer Neymar. However, I am signaling Neymar that Jair is sharpening his skills to move up the football ranks. And who knows, a battle prowess may ensue and adoration suddenly morphs into something even more spectacular. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I have just presented the students of Year 6 Makekron. To my students, I pray that you keep your eyes on the prize. Never give up. And please remember to pray and always give thanks.
Pierce Banks is a thinker and a confident student. He always has a different perspective to share. He actively participates in lessons and demonstrates effort in academic work. He respects rights, opinions, and property of others. He works independently and continues to improve in his academic goals. Once he is focused and listens keenly to instructions, he can be self-sufficient during independent work periods. Pierce does well in mathematics and is always very eager to explain and show. He is a student with a competitive nature and a positive attitude towards his academic pursuits. Jordan Bergman. It's an absolute pleasure to teach her the last 2 years. She is a disciplined and a very pleasant young lady. She's a prefect. Her conduct is exemplary and has made steady progression in her work. Jordan has a good sense of humor and gets on well with her peers. She has grown in confidence and is not afraid to express her opinion. She has a high level of independent working skills and works well in a group situation. She's a deep thinker, enjoys mathematics, and will not do anything unless the concept is clear. She's involved in track and field, basketball, and art and craft. Jordan is an active member of the Cayman Islands Aquatic Club and represented the Cayman Islands in synchronized swimming worldwide invitational in Coral Springs. Isabella Bodden is a charismatic individual who has blossomed into a lovely young lady. She is quiet, soft-spoken, but one who has grown in confidence this year. Isabella is a prefect and a member of the football team. She is a passionate reader. She reads with very good diction and makes good contribution to class discussion. She has worked very hard to improve her progress. She has a melodious voice and is an artist who inspires others with her creative ideas. She's a deep thinker, enjoys mathematics, and tries to do her best at given tasks. She must be commended for her dedication and active participation during online sessions. Maximilian Brown. He has grown into a lovely student. He is very helpful, respectful, and always volunteering to do things. His conduct is exemplary and is among the most improved. He works with enthusiasm, participates well in lessons, and approaches his work with a positive attitude. He shows interest in mathematics, especially, and has been putting in a lot of effort in his learning. He's a confident student, very articulate, and not afraid to express his opinion. He must be commended for his progress. He was an active member of the football team. Naya Brown is a polite and friendly student. She is a quiet member of the class who has a considerate and thoughtful nature. She made good progress to work independently and work with others. She's always helpful and willing to undertake jobs around the classroom. Her confidence level has grown and willingly participates in lessons this year. Mahershal Durant is a conversationalist with convincing arguments. Quite a charismatic individual who is usually cheerful and has a good sense of humor. She's a confident member of the class and participates well in lessons, thus having a positive attitude towards all aspects of her work. She has a high level of independent working skills and takes pride in her work as it is always neat and presentable. She reads with good diction and is a creative writer. She has been putting in a lot of effort in her learning. Mahershal is a prefect and sets a superb example. She is the class's singing bird, thus a member of the school's junior choir. She is also an active member of football, netball, dance, and track team. She is crowned the school's Champion Girl 2020. Christo Durant is a quiet member of the class and speaks when it is absolutely necessary. He is considerate and has a thoughtful nature. He has a good sense of humor and enjoys sharing jokes with his classmates and teacher alike. However, he can be a very focused student who works very hard and always gives his best effort in all areas of the curriculum. Quite a competitive student he is and never gives up until he gets the correct answer. He is a critical thinker, does well in mathematics, and quite a descriptive writer. He is a prefect and a good role model. He is an active member of basketball and an incredible footballer where he represents the Cayman Islands both locally and internationally. He is a member of the track team and was crowned the school's Champion Boy 2020. He is a winner and must be commended for all his efforts. He was an active participant during online sessions explaining concepts and uploading all his tasks. Caden Ebanks is a prefect. He has a very positive attitude towards all aspects of his schoolwork and sets a good example with his behavior. He's extremely conscientious, producing work to be really proud of. He is very organized as his workspace is always neat and well kept. He has a high level of independent working skills, a confident member of the class, and contributes well in lessons. Caden is a member of the track team where he represented well on sports day. He is also an active member of football and basketball. He was dedicated to online learning and always the first to upload his task. Trey Grant. Trey has been a great addition to the class. He is a polite and friendly individual. He has a good sense of humor and enjoys sharing a joke with children and adults alike. He demonstrates effort in academic work and contributes well in the discussions and group work. He is a confident student and is not afraid to express his opinion. He has worked very hard to improve his progress over time. He is a critical thinker and does well mathematically. He was an active member of robotics. It was a pleasure teaching Trey. Kayla Hamilton is very polite and respectful. She is a member of the after-school club Girl Guide. She exercises self-control and follows rules and directions well. She is focused and stays on task. Kayla has a positive attitude towards all aspects of her schoolwork and shows independence. Her confidence has grown and is a capable student. She is an avid reader where she reads a variety of books and has achieved full fluency in her reading. Kayla has good expression when reading aloud. She writes well-structured stories, uses interesting detail and expressive words. Amaya Jervis is respectful, kind, and thoughtful to her peers and adults alike. She is very quiet in class, but tries to participate and work at given tasks in small groups. She has grown in confidence this year and willingly raises her hand to share her opinion. Amaya was committed to online learning and participated well in teams. Aiden Miller. Aiden has been a fantastic addition to the class. He is a friendly member who works with enthusiasm and regularly contributes to class discussions. He is always helpful to his peers and a good peer tutor. He is a prefect and a good role model. Aiden is a member of the cricket, basketball, and football club in which he has represented the school well in tournaments. He makes good effort and works hard on tasks given. He's an excellent reader, comprehends well, and writes creatively, as he is very imaginative. He is a confident student, very articulate, and not afraid to express his opinion. He must be commended for all his efforts this year. Aiden was committed to online classes and was dedicated to submitting all his tasks. Joni Moulton. Joni comes to school ready every day. She is a confident student and always has a different perspective to share. She is kind, polite, and thoughtful, always willing to help. She's a prefect and a good role model as she is very respectful, exercises self-control, and follows rules and directions. She's a focused student, one who demonstrates excellent effort in academic work as she works independently. She has achieved full fluency in her reading and has good expression when reading aloud. Joni's general written work is coherently structured and well executed. Her imaginative writing has interesting ideas and she gives careful thought to making the meaning clear. She's a critical thinker and comprehends well. Joni is very active in school and is a member of netball, steel pan, football, dance, and basketball club. She was a dedicated online learner and was eager to share her discoveries. Nathan Miles. Nathan has impressively made a positive turnaround with his behavior. He has grown and matured into a lovely young man. He's very polite and has become quite helpful to his peers and teachers alike. He's now confident, focused, and willingly participates in lessons. Nathan works best in small groups and approaches his work with seriousness. He shows interest in science and mathematics. He's an artist and inspires others with his drawings. He's an active member of the basketball team. Nathan was committed to online learning and participated well, submitting his assignments in team. Sean Michael Powell. Sean is a very calm student and is a faithful peer tutor. He is very articulate, who confidently expresses his opinion. He makes good effort and works hard on tasks. He's an avid reader, one who reads with expression and feelings. He comprehends well. This has allowed him to write well-structured sentences as he makes good word choices. He listens keenly in class and follows directions well. He must be commended for his efforts over the year. Sean willingly participated in online learning and uploaded all his tasks. Justice Ramon Dixon. Justice is a prefect who is polite, respectful, and a good role model. She exercises self-control and follows rules and directions. She listens well in discussions and joins in with more enthusiasm. She generally thinks carefully about the point she's trying to get over to others. Justice's schoolwork and projects are always well presented. She reads a variety of books and comprehends well. She's a competitive individual and approaches her work with a positive attitude. Her stories are usually nicely planned and imaginative. She's an active member of the basketball and netball team. She submitted high-quality work and was committed to online learning activities. Camille Rankin. Camille has blossomed into a lovely student, and it has been a pleasure teaching her. She is polite and a respectful individual. She's a prefect and a good role model. She exercises self-control and follows rules and directions well. Camille has become focused and takes her schoolwork seriously. Her classwork and projects are always well presented. She has been putting in a lot of effort in her learning and has become a confident student. She's a progressive individual who is an active athlete and a member of the football team. She was committed to online learning and uploaded her work in a timely manner. Christiana Ransom Grant. Christiana is quite a character and an energetic student. He has a good sense of humor that engages his classmates during any downtime. A conversationalist he is, and always has a different perspective to share. He is a prefect and tries to be a good role model, as he is very respectful. He demonstrates excellent effort in academic work. Cristiano's general written work is coherently structured and well executed. His imaginative writing has interesting ideas. He is a critical thinker who does well in mathematics and science and is always eager to share his knowledge with his teacher and classmates. Cristiano is a member of the school's football, robotics, and track team. David Reed. David is polite and respectful. He has matured in the last 2 years. He has a wonderful sense of humor and gets along well with his classmates. He has grown in confidence and willingly participates in discussions. He works well in small groups and tries to work independently on given tasks. He is a committed online learner and participated well in team. Thea Reed. Thea has matured into a beautiful young lady. She is kind, polite, thoughtful, and is such a humble individual. She is the deputy head girl and a good role model, as she is respectful, exercises self-control, and follows rules and directions. She demonstrates excellent effort in academic work and works well independently. She's an avid reader who reads a variety of books and has good expression when reading aloud. Thea's general written work is coherently structured and well executed. Her imaginative writing is creative and has interesting ideas, as she gives careful thought to making the meaning clear. Thea has done extremely well across the curriculum. She's very active in school and is a member of dance, netball, steel pan, football, and basketball. Thea must be commended for active participation and explanation of concepts during online sessions. Lucas Richardson. Lucas is a pleasant student who gets along well with his classmates. He has a good sense of humor and enjoys sharing jokes with his classmates. However, he has a positive attitude towards all aspects of his schoolwork and sets a good example with his behavior. He's a prefect and a good role model. He's extremely conscientious, producing work to be proud of. He is very organized, as his workspace is always neat and well kept. He has a high level of independent working skills, a confident member of the class, and contributes well in lessons. Lucas is an active member of football and basketball, who represented the school well in tournaments. He is committed to online learning and uploaded all his tasks. Aiden Rivers. Aiden has matured into a lovely young man. He is respectful, kind, and thoughtful to his peers and adults alike. He can be very reserved, as he is very quiet in class, but tries to participate and work at given tasks in small groups. He has grown in confidence this year and willingly raises his hand to share his opinion. Aiden is an athlete and is a key member of the track team. He is also a member of the football team. He is committed to online learning and participated well in teams. Joshua Rodriguez. Joshua is a polite and respectful individual. He joined the school recently and had just begun settling into class and making friends. He enjoys playing football with his classmates and was a great addition to the school's choir and drama team. With the shelter in place, we have not had the opportunity to get to know him better. Isaiah Scott. Isaiah is a polite and respectful student. He has increased in his efforts and has grown in confidence. He now participates in lessons willingly and shows interest in mathematics. He reads a variety of texts and comprehends well. His handwriting has improved and his work is presentable. Once he's focused and listens keenly to instructions, he can be self-sufficient during independent work periods. He's an active member of the football team. Jaden Scott. Jaden is a deputy head boy and his conduct is exemplary. He is polite and follows instructions well. He has been putting in a lot of effort in his learning. Jaden is a critical thinker and does well in mathematics especially. He is a class's scientist as he enjoys experiments and represented the school at science fairs where he was featured. Jaden is a confident student who is not afraid to share his opinion. He has achieved full fluency in his reading and has good expression when reading aloud. It was discovered lately that he has a melodious voice but is shy about it. He makes a good addition to the school's choir and drama group. He is also a member of the cricket team. He is focused and is a committed online learner. Thalia Tomlinson. Thalia has matured over the year. She is a prefect and tries to be a good role model. She is respectful to her teachers and classmates. She has grown in confidence and prefers to work in small groups. She has made an effort in her learning this year. She is also an active member of the dance group. Isaiah Willis. Isaiah has matured over time. He has increased his efforts and has made progress in his behavior this year. He has beautiful handwriting and has worked hard to improve this. He is a thinker and tries his best to solve problems in mathematics. He works independently and continues to improve in his academic goals. Isaiah has grown in confidence and always has a different perspective to share. He is quite an energetic student who does well in track and field and football. I wish for all of you every success in high school.
We now invite our Vice Principal, Mrs. Joylyn Ebanks King, to chair the special awards.
Now follows the 2020 Special Awards. These awards are given to recognize those students who have excelled in one or more areas of school life. The Lucille Seymour Citizenship Award is sponsored by Miss Lucille Seymour. This award is presented each year to one student who has demonstrated the following characteristics: reliability, dependability, initiative, and a willingness to complete any task that is required. The recipient of this award is Quintina Morias. Special Academic Awards. The Special Academic Awards are presented to those students whose work and dedication demonstrate the importance of maintaining excellent academic grades. These students exemplify our school motto, committed to excellence. The recipients of the Special Academic Awards are recognized for their consistency in exceeding the required benchmark in science, literacy, numeracy, or high academic performance in both literacy and numeracy. Academic Awards for Science. The recipients of the Special Academic Awards for Science are Garson Gardner, Alexa Moyton, Joni Moulton, Isaiah Miles, Ryan Pickard, Cristiano Ransom Grant, Lucas Richardson, and Jaden Scott. Academic Awards for Numeracy. The recipients of the Special Academic Awards for Numeracy are Andre Alexander, Pierce Banks, Ciara Bergman, Charles Chambers, Gisela McCoy, Ryan Pickard, Sean Michael Powell, Lucas Richardson, Nasir Smith, Tevez Verona, and Jair Willis. Academic Awards for Literacy. The recipients of the Special Academic Awards for Literacy are Maheshal Durant, Anaya Lopez, Aiden Miller, and Isaiah McCain. High Academic Awards for both Literacy and Numeracy. The recipients of the High Academic Awards for both Literacy and Numeracy are Janae Cunningham, Christo Durant, Caden Ebanks, Tiana Ebanks, Garson Gardner, Gemma General, Alexa Moyton, Quintina Moraes, Joni Moulton, Isaiah Miles, Justice Ramon Dixon, Cristiano Ransom Grant, Brianna Ramjeet Flores, Thea Reed, Jaden Scott, and Leah Warren. Save Our Youth Foundation Achievement Certificate. This medallion is awarded to students who have demonstrated one or more of the following: ability to lead and inspire others by example, significant academic improvement, exemplary attitude and behavior, love for the learning process, community spirit for school and the Cayman Islands. The recipients of the Soy Foundation Achievement Awards are Maya Bates, Jordan Bergman, Ciara Bergman, Isabella Bodden, Maximilian Brown, Amaya McLaughlin, Nathan Miles, Kezia Parchment, Aiden Rivers, and Jair Willis. The PYP Spirit Award. This award recognizes students who exemplify the qualities and characteristics as outlined in the Attitudes and Learner Profile. Recipients of the PYP Spirit Awards are Jordan Bergman, Maximilian Brown, Gisela McCoy, and Anaya Lopez. Music Awards. The Music Awards are presented to students who have participated enthusiastically and successfully in all musical activities and have demonstrated passion and competency. They have presented and performed at various functions, both at school and within the wider community. Over the years, these students have performed excellently in the following areas: vocal, wind instruments, stringed instruments, steel pan. Recipients of the Music Awards are Maheshal Durant, Tiana Ebanks, Garson Gardner, Alexa Moyton, Quintina Moraes, Joni Moulton, Isaiah Miles, Thea Reed, and Leah Warren. Sports Recognition Certificates. These students have demonstrated dedication in representing their school in athletics. They have exercised self-discipline, self-control, and respect. These students have been outstanding in one or more of the following sports: track and field, basketball, football, netball, swimming, and cricket. The recipients of the Sports Recognition Certificates are Maya Bates, Jordan Bergman, Ciara Bergman, Janae Cunningham, Caden Ebanks, Tiana Ebanks, Khadija Gardner, Gemma General, Isaiah McCain, Aiden Miller, Quintina Moraes, Nathan Miles, Camille Rankin, Lucas Richardson, Justice Ramon Dixon, Emmy Ramos, Cristiano Ransom Grant, Tevez Verona, Leah Warren, and Isaiah Willis. The Winner Circle Awards. These students have demonstrated athletic prowess. They have proven themselves to be invaluable in supporting the success of our school's sports teams this year. They have also consistently displayed a competitive edge, good sportsmanship, and a desire to win. These students will also receive the Sports Recognition Certificate. The recipients of the Winner Circle Awards for the boys are Christo Durant, Isaiah Miles, Nasir Smith, and Jair Willis. The recipients of the Winner Circle Awards for the girls are Maheshal Durant, Alexa Moyton, Kezia Parchment, and Thea Reed. The CARE Awards. These awards are presented to students who exemplify the meaning of CARE based on the values of Prospect Primary School. This embodies cooperation, attitude, respect, and excellence. The recipients of the CARE Awards are
Joni Molden and Tiana Ebanks.
The Principal's Cup. Each year, we name a valedictorian to receive the Principal's Cup. Our valedictorian must always exemplify our motto, committed to excellence in all that he or she does. This student must always be a role model to his or her peers and display the following skills and attributes: outstanding academic performance, superb leadership skills, self-discipline at all times, involvement in all aspects of school life, exemplary conduct throughout the years in school, a caring, responsible, and respectful individual, an individual who handles success with humility. Our winner this year has shown these attributes consistently. The winner for the Principal's Cup for the class of 2020 is Isaiah Miles. This concludes the special awards presentations. I now invite Mrs. Risan Moyton, President of the PTA, to present the Parent Recognition Awards.
Good evening, all. Protocol having been observed, it is with great pleasure I stand before you on this truly momentous occasion. My name is Risan Moyton, PTA President for the Prospect Primary School for the 2019-2020 academic year. It seems so long ago, in August of 2019, when this bright-eyed and bushy-tailed group of Year 6 students commenced their final year at Prospect Primary School. Fast forward to today, what a year of change it has been. On behalf of the Prospect Primary School PTA Executive and the wider parent body, congratulations to the 2020 school leaving class of Prospect Primary School. I will remember. We will remember. We salute you, the students who persevered with a steely determination to complete this year 6 against many odds. We salute you, the teachers and assistant teachers who worked tirelessly over many long hours, embracing new technologies to ensure delivery and continuity of education. Thank you. We salute you, the principal, vice principal, and senior management team, for your leadership and direction as you also grappled with the enormity of change. We salute you, parents, guardians, and extended family members, for balancing the demands of working from home as well as homeschooling. We have a newfound respect for our educators and teachers. Your commitment to our children is truly unfailing and unyielding. It is at this juncture I would like to make a very special announcement. It is with the greatest honor and the deepest pride I unveil the Levi Allen Award for parent recognition. For those parents whose commitment to Prospect Primary School deserves recognition. One may ask, who is Mr. Levi Allen? Mr. Levi Allen was a fervent, dedicated parent of Prospect Primary School, an articulate, energetic, and passionate parent who challenged the PTA executive and school to strive for excellence in everything we did. An exemplary man, father, colleague, and friend. One of the utmost character and integrity. That is Mr. Levi Allen. The following parents are the first ever recipients of the Levi Allen Parents Recognition Award. We salute you for your commitment and service over the past 7 years to the students, staff, and parents of Prospect Primary School. And in no particular order, as follows. Mrs. Judy Ann Miles, Mr. and Mrs. Trent and Belinda Grant, Mrs. Venetia Parchment, Miss Perla Allen, Miss Nicole Powell, Miss Sochil Caballero, Miss Hani Flores, Miss Shakira Mitu, Miss Alexandra Saintville, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Becky Miller, and Mrs. Marva Reed. Thank you for your service and dedication to Prospect Primary School. Thank you for affording me the honor of speaking at tonight's school leaving ceremony. We wish the greatest of successes to the students as they embark on the next chapter of their educational journeys heading towards high school. We know that this year of change has adequately prepared you for all that is yet to come. And we know that you will continue to persevere, recognizing that this year has taught you the importance of endurance and resilience. Thank you.
We extend very special thanks to Mrs. Ebanks King and all the other presenters of the special awards. As we approach the end of our ceremony, we ask Thea Reed to present the vote of thanks on behalf of the student body.
Special guests, principal, teachers, and staff, parents and relatives, our delightful Cayman audience. We are indeed happy that you can join us in our first virtual school leaving ceremony for Prospect Primary School. On behalf of my fellow classmates and friends and the entire Prospect Primary School family, we thank you all for celebrating with us today. We will remember a theme so fitting for this auspicious occasion. Class of 2020, we know how to make an impact. We were the first students to enter reception classes at Prospect Primary School, and we are the first students to leave via a virtual celebration. What a dynamic milestone in our lives. Call us special, that we are. We have already reached a decade with some, little, or no birthday celebrations. But we have experienced the Cayman Islands' largest earthquake, 6.4 magnitude, the most major dump fire, a worldwide pandemic, COVID-19. And of course, let us not forget another winning of Matfield House for Prospect Primary School Sports Day, all in the span of 2 months for 2020. So it has been bittersweet. I would like to thank our Almighty God, for without Him, nothing is possible. He has protected us through all of this, and as a result, we are now a more resilient group of students who will continue on our journey and forge ahead into a brilliant future, making our parents proud and maintaining our Prospect Primary School motto, committed to excellence. Graduates, as a noun, it signifies a person who has successfully completed a course of study or training. Now that's a huge word for us, as we are now faced with the task of living up to higher expectation of all individuals who have contributed to this platform in our lives. Who do we thank for that? Thanks today for our keynote speaker, Mr. Jonathan Smelly. Your message is motivational and has given us a lot to reflect on. We wish you all success throughout your journeys. A very special thank you to all the dignitaries that we have met during the past 7 years. Our representatives from the Ministry of Education, Department of Education, other ministries, and the wider Cayman community. Thanks to the many organizations who have contributed and donated special awards and certificates to our ceremony. Every time we hold or look at them, it will be a constant reminder of what you mean to us. On behalf of every school leaver from the class of 2020, I wish to extend a huge and special thank you to all stakeholders in our journey at Prospect Primary School. Our principals, deputy principals, and teachers, past and present. All staff, vendor employees, and volunteers. A shiny bright thank you to our dentist nurse Alice. I wish we had given you a quarter for every tooth you extracted. A special thank you to our bus drivers and wardens. Trust we did not drive you too crazy during our journeys. To Mr. Thomas, our security, for helping to protect us. To each and every one, please know that you have left an impact and made a memorable difference in our lives. Without your vision, your commitment, especially during the past months, your support, your prayers, your encouragement, and your voice echoing even in our sleeps, our achievements today would not have been accomplished. Our class teachers, who have been with us for years 5 and 6, Ms. Harris and Ms. McEachran, you are probably the only ones that know us better than our parents. A special thank you for all your hard work and dedication to education. I quote, "A good teacher is like a candle. It consumes itself to light the way for others." By Mustafa Kemal Ataturk. We also extend our appreciation to the Prospect Primary School PTA and its executive members. Thanks for all that you do for our school. We encourage all parents to get involved and support the PTA. Lastly, we would like to thank a special group of persons who have been blessed and privileged to call us their children. Parents, guardians, and family members, thank you so much for believing in us, investing in us, and supporting us. We cannot say how much we love and salute you. Just know you are stuck with us for still a long time. As I close, I would like to again extend a huge, tremendous thanks to everyone for celebrating today with us. As you sit watching this ceremony with your child or children, reach over, hug them, and tell them how proud you are of them. Fellow classmates, hug your parents and family members and tell them a huge thank you and that you love and appreciate all that they have done for you. To my fellow classmates and friends, I share a famous quote with you by Maya Angelou. People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. Know that this is not the end of the class of 2020. It's only the beginning. Not only will we remember, but we will be remembered. Thank you from Prospect Primary School, class of 2020.
As we say farewell to our Year 6 students, there are a few members of staff whom sadly we also have to say farewell to. Firstly, Mr. James Downs. Mr. Downs has only been with us a short while, but it has been a very exciting time, what with the close down. He worked really hard with his class to ensure that distance learning continued and has certainly won the respect of his students and his parents alike. Good luck, Mr. Downs. Miss Alex Howells has worked across the school as our maths coach this year. She certainly brought a lot to the school and really supported staff and students alike with the improvement in mathematics. Miss Howells, thank you for all of your hard work. You've been a great addition to the team and you're really going to be missed next year. We wish you all the best in the future. Take care. Miss Andrea Nixon. Miss Andrea Nixon has been our school inclusion specialist, working with some of our children to really help them to access school and to make it a success of their day-to-day education. We were going to really miss having Miss Andrea around because she's one of those can-do people. She always has a smile for everyone and always brightens everyone's day. Miss Andrea, we wish you all the best in your new post. Good luck. Mrs. Pam Smith. Mrs. Smith joined us last year as a Year 2 class teacher and moved this year to Year 1. We're really going to miss Mrs. Smith for all of her artistry, her creativity and fun that she brings to her classroom. I know that the children are going to miss her and I'll be very sorry to see her go. Mrs. Smith, we'd like to wish you all the best for the future. Take care. Finally, we say farewell to Miss Samantha Frederick. Miss Frederick joined the school as a one-to-one support for a child in Year 3. And I know that she is going to be hugely missed by Eon, who has really become her third child here at Prospect. Miss Frederick is leaving us to go to live with her family in the Brack, and she'll be taking with her her two sons, Noah and Joseph, who we will also miss. They're such lovely boys. We wish all of them the very best for their new life in the Brack, and certainly we'll be looking to hear lots of tales about their adventures on the Bluff. I wish you all the best for the future and hope you have a wonderful time. Take care.
We now ask for a blessing on our school leaving class.
Good day, everyone. First and foremost, I'd like to say hearty congratulations to the Year 6 school leavers of the Prospect Primary School. You have made us proud. And as your theme rightly says, we will remember. We will remember every smile, every challenge, and every success. Let us pray. Most righteous and eternal God, we want to tell you how much we appreciate you and we love you. And we also want to tell you, Lord God, we appreciate and love each and every one of the students that are leaving the Prospect Primary School this year. We pray, God, that you'll guide God and protect them. We ask you, Lord, that you'll go before them, our God, and make their way successful. Father, I pray that you'll grant them the wisdom, Lord, the wisdom to make the right decisions for their future. Father God, I pray that you'll also bless their parents and all their teachers. Let your perfect will be accomplished in their lives. Dear God, I ask you that you'll guide their very footsteps, order their steps according to your word and your ways. Dear God, we place all of them over into your hand. And we ask you, Lord, that you will, oh God, grant them the direction that will cause them to fulfill all the plans that you have for their lives. We thank you for hearing and answering even now. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.
Of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If this time has taught me anything, it is that the tiny speck in this universe that we occupy is both wonderful and wondrous. And if we allow it to, the beauty around us can unlock the beauty within us and teach us far more than our schooling ever did. If this time has taught me anything, it is that success and how we measure it needs to be redefined, and that the only person to whom you should ever compare yourself is who you were yesterday. Make your growth game strong, and along the way be kind to yourself. If you are doing your best, then you are doing enough. If this time has taught me anything, it is that it is more important now than ever before to see the world through your own eyes. Begin by looking at yourself. Look honestly and look gently. Look inward with compassion and kindness, and look outward with humility and appreciation. If this time has taught me anything, it is that the opposite of love is not hate but fear. And our greatest fear is losing that to which we have become attached. Yesterday is heavy. Put it down. Seeing the beauty in the world around you is the first step in purifying and clearing the mind. And if this time has taught me anything, it is that nature, unlike us, never apologizes for her beauty. If this time has taught me anything, it is that life really is about the journey, not the destination. And it must be. For surely we are not here merely to reach the destination, for the destination is death. Be alive, for after all, life is all you've got. And when you pay attention to the things for which you are grateful, you soon forget about what you think you're missing. If this time has taught me anything, it is that bitter tears are the quietest, and on the days when your head wants to hang low, it is important that you look up, lift your head, take it in and breathe deep, for while this world can sometimes be a hard place, your reality and what you perceive it to be are seldom aligned. If this time has taught me anything, it is that beauty truly is in the eye of the beholder. We can see universes within universes, but only when we pay enough attention. And this is as true of the nature within us as it is of the nature around us. If this time has taught me anything, it is this. If true love conquers everything, then self-love gives it the fortitude to do so. Know that you are more than your scars. Know that every wound in you that has healed along the way has taught you what it is to fight back and to start again from where you are with what you've got. beat your own pathway without seeking the approval of others, and know that self-love is not vanity. If this time has taught me anything, it is this: hope matters, and we cannot live without it. This time has taught me that hope is not a wish, nor a desire for things to be different. It is a course of action, a combination of mind and heart. The future can be better and can be brighter, and we each have the power within us to make it so. There will be challenges to face along the way, to which there are many solutions. There is a source of resilience deep within us all. If this time does not teach us that time itself is precious, then we will have missed the lesson. The lesson that never before have the past and the future been so irrelevant, and that the quest to find ourselves has been fruitless to now, only because we've been searching in all the wrong places. We are here. We are now. We are each and every breath we take. Every day is a gift to begin again, and to grasp with both hands the fresh opportunity to learn, unlearn, and relearn. If this time is not wasted.
Yes, this time has taught us that no man, no woman, no boy, no girl is an island. We all need each other to lean on, to hold your hands, to wipe away a tear, to pray with and for us, to provide us with guidance and advice, because two heads, two minds are always better than one. Yes, this time has taught us to be frugal, fiscally responsible, to prioritize budgets, to reorganize plans, to get out of our comfort zone, to navigate uncharted waters and turbulent seas, to reach deep, to find a fresh supply of patience in times when we felt overwhelmed, to exercise our faith even when it seemed like all we had was trembling faith. Yes, this time has taught us to look unto God, from whence cometh our help. It has taught us to be still and to know that God is God, and it is He that has made us and not we ourselves. Yes, this time has taught us that we can accomplish all things through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. That despite coronavirus, circumstances in Cayman, and indeed the entire world, our God is a faithful God. His blessings are new each and every morning. Yes, this time has taught us the usefulness of online learning, e-commerce, computers, smartphones, internet, Wi-Fi, broadband, reliable electricity is the new norm. Yes, this time COVID-19 has coerced and propelled us into the world of technology, and there is no turning back to blackboards. Instead, smart boards and laptops for all, as no child will be left behind. Yes, this time has taught us that education is not a luxury, but a necessity. It is not for the privileged alone, but for every boy and girl that enters our classroom and that have been entrusted to our care. That where there's a will, there is a way. And cynicism, criticism, carnality, covetousness, contagious fake news are not essential components for a strong coalition and a cooperative yet competitive Soren Soul. Yes, this time has taught us that cost it what it may, we must nation build. Yes, nation build. Develop our young, bright minds. Challenge the average minds. Facilitate and augment the struggling mind so that together we can and will have an educated country, and each of you students can and must find your place in this our Caymanian community, and indeed the world if you so desire. Yes, this time has taught us that hard work and determination does pay off, and if we successfully reach our goals in life, that we are fearfully and wonderfully made, created equal and genetically encoded to succeed. Yes, this time, class of 2020, is your time. The time is now. Tomorrow is promised to no one. But you are somebody. Enjoy your tomorrows with and in it comes. Each of you represent an important building block in our nation. History, past, present, and future. We therefore need all of you. We support you. We wish you all that is good as you set your eyes, heart, mind for excellence here in this life and in the life to come. We are in this together, and failing is not an option. Believe in yourselves and in others. Lean on others when necessary, and likewise, be a shoulder for others when down to lean on. Utilize your reservoir of knowledge to harness wisdom and understanding, and cultivate a heart of love, care, kindness, compassion, discernment, and Cayman kindness. Yes, this time of COVID-19 has been far from normal, but it has offered each and every one of us a new opportunity to reset our GPS and get on the right track, to keep on the right track. So students, purpose like Daniel of old to be brave, courageous, committed, and set and achieve your goals. Keep God as the central focus in your life. God bless you, your parents, guardians, teachers and faculty, family and friends, and God bless these beloved Cayman Islands. Congratulations, graduates. Go light your candle and make this world a better place.